Open a new document in Affinity Photo and go to the Vector Tools, or maybe the Pen Tool, and create a load of vector designs, something like this. Maybe ellipses, circles, whatever. Once you've got that, what you can do, File, and down to Export, and you can save it as a vector format file, SVG. Of course, it could have images in as well as text and much, much more. Got whole document, so I want to save that. And I'm just going to say export. And it's only 2.82 kilobytes. And this document could be tried 2,000 by 2,000, 20,000 by 20,000. So export. And I'm going to save it as 2.svg. So just save it like that. It's a vector format. And I can open it in a number of different applications. So I'm just going to go to Safari. So go to Safari. And I can say File and down to Open File. And now I can select 2.svg. You can see one that I've already created earlier. That was 1.svg. And you can see the vector design. And it can be any size. So you can make it very small. So obviously it's great for mobile phones or whatever. Or you can make it really, really large. Also, you can tweak it as well. You can actually view it as well. You can just go here in the develop and just go down to show versus. And I never get it right. Show page source. That's the thing you need. Show page source. And you can go through these and you can see the code there. And of course, you can tweak it in a text pad, notepad, whatever you've got. Also, of course, if you've got like something like Dreamweaver, you always go to Dreamweaver. And you can say File and you go to Open. And you can say 2.svg. And you can bring it in here. And of course, you can then edit it or do View and Live Code. And so on. So you can see the same design there as in Affinity Photo. Well, I hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.